The Bible tells us that that's the highest praise you can give God. Amen. Hallelujah. So, did you come with a praise in your heart today? Amen. Father God, we just thank you. Thank you for being the true living God that you are. Hallelujah. Lord, we just want to bless your holy name. And we want to come with thanksgiving in our hearts, Lord. Thanksgiving for all that you've done and all that you're going to do, Lord. For your promises are true. And amen. Amen to that word. Now, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we just ask you to bless this service today, Father. Let every voice be lifted to in praise to you, to your goodness. And Lord, we just want to thank you for your son right now. Thank you for Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, for the blood that he shed and making a way that we could truly know who you are and be able to be in your presence, Father. But we know that true death is without you. And Lord, as long as you are with us, Lord, we know that life is eternal. And Lord, we thank you for that right now. Father, we ask you to bless those that are weak in mind, weak in their bodies. Father, we ask you for a mighty touch today. Lord, let your Holy Spirit have its way, Father. And we're going to give you praise and glory. And all God's people said, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Morning, everyone. Happy Father's Day to all of the dads out here this morning. Amen. The Father God is raising up godly men to train up their children in the way that they should go so that they will not depart upon it. You have a big responsibility, dads. Hallelujah. Thank you. few minutes and go visit one another. We got some visitors. Welcome, Mom. Welcome. Attack. It was, I know it was a spiritual attack because when Pastor asked him to pray for me Thursday, it broke and it lifted off of me, but it is the worst oppression that I have ever had, where I just was hopeless, giving up, just crying out to God every morning, God, help me. And there was one morning I got up and I could not speak anything in English at all. There was just nothing there. And I began to pray in the Holy Ghost. That's why that song really meant something this morning, because I saw the importance in this hour to be able to speak in other tongues. So today, if you do not have that gift and the invitation comes forth in the service, I'm letting you know, we need that gift in the days we're living in. Because it would not be a spirit of oppression that I thought would have taken me out. But I can see that that could happen to us. Amen? Hallelujah. So we thank the Lord for the Holy Ghost this morning.
Tell me whose reports believe, we shall believe.
this report, will you believe?
We shall believe the report of the Lord.
Whose report will you believe?
We shall believe the report of the Lord.
Tell me whose report will you believe? Yeah.
We shall believe the report of the Lord.
Tell me whose report will you believe?
We shall believe the report of the Lord.
Cause his report says.
as you begin to fly. Come on strong, Yahweh. Come on strong, Yahweh.
Oh, yeah.
Come on strong, Yahweh.
Come on,
come on strong, Yahweh.
Oh, come on
strong, Yahweh. Come on strong. Yeah.
stand amazed. Glory. I said, we give you all the glory.
Glory.
We give you all the praise.
Glory.
You are the great and mighty glory. God, and we stand amazed. Say with me. Amazed at the greatness of who our God is. I heard him say, you know, we keep him so small in this box, and he is a great and mighty God doing wonders in the earth today. So we are here to give him all glory, all honor, and all praise. We worship you, Father. Worship you for who you are, oh God.
Thank you.
to God.
So blow.
Fire burn
so
in
love.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, we worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We lift your name on high, Father God.
Hallelujah.
You are worthy. You are
hallelujah.
Worthy.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah
to our God.
Hallelujah.
Praise
praise you, Father. Praise you, Father God. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Father God.
Praise you, Father.
Glorious one. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glorious one. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus.
Jesus.
We worship Jesus. Jesus. We glorify the Lamb of God. You who sits Jesus, upon the throne.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Oh God, we thank you, oh God, for your presence, oh God. We thank you, Father God, that you are our God. We are your people, oh God. That you've called us by your name, oh God. Redeemed us, oh God. Washed us in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Jesus, hallelujah.
Oh, Father.
Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Hallelujah.
Thy kingdom come.
Praise you, Lord.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
For I inhabit the praises of my people, say the Lord. And I am glad to be in amongst your midst today, saith the Lord. Know that I'm here, and I love you, and I care for you. And I do not wish you harm or evil, saith the Lord. Even if the enemy would come in like a flood, does not my word say that I will bring up a standard to bear against him, saith the Lord. For I love the praises of my people, saith the Lord. It touches my heart. And then I am there to heal. I am there to save. I am there to drive back the evil one who would wish you harm, to wish to devour you, and who would wish to kill you. But I have lifted up my standard that nothing against you shall prosper, saith the Lord. And to know that I am with you and I care for you and I love you because you guys are my servants, saith the Lord. And I love that you praise me and worship me because I inhabit the praises of my people.
Any song that you guys can sing together, come up here and sing. Get on my microphone.
She's like, oh my God.
Today's Father's Day.
Today would be the day to come like that.
I'm sorry, sing a Father's Day song. Hey, we're going to get you a mic. Yeah, just put all this one on the phone. So, tell them what's been going on. You guys know who this is?
Yes.
This is Linda's son, sister Brenda, that was here and then she moved to Texas. Where the heat's at. Is there a lot of floods out there right now? Yes, thank you, Lord. Oh, look, she's got two mics. She's going to try to talk Jackie into doing it. Put that camera right on down, bro.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay. And I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name.
Flips me over to John and says, do this. So I've never preached this message before in my life. We're just going to go with the flow. Somebody lift your hands up for a minute and worship God just for a second. Everybody lift your voices up. I want to hear everybody say, Lord, we love you. A little bit louder. I can't hear you. Lord, we love you. You're worthy to be praised. We love your direction. We love your purpose. We love your mind. We love your heart. Thank you, Lord. Now, as I'm doing this message today, some of you are not going to agree with this one little part in here. You're going to go, no, 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 not me. But it's true. I believe it is. John chapter 18. And Jackie, honey, you're going to have to read real slow. When the anointing's on me, I can't hardly read at all. You know, it's hard to see those words when the presence is on you. It's hard to see so and soldier and all kinds of stuff. Now, in John 18 chapter, let's go from 12 until I stop you. But you're going to have to read slow, okay? Hold on a minute. Jesus went before the high priest here, and Scripture says that Peter denied Jesus. And that's the part that sometimes we go, oh, now that would never happen to me. Well, it happened to him. He denied him three times. Okay, Jacqueline, would you take off with verse 12?
Then the band and the captain and the officers of the Jews took Jesus and bound him.
Now, wait a minute. Let's get in the same translation. New reverse, revived standard. Do you have that? You got it? Throw it up there.
So the soldiers, their officer, and the Jewish police arrested Jesus and bound
him. So there were soldiers here, officers, and Jewish police that came to arrest Jesus. That'd be a big deal. It'd be like soldiers marching in here right now, great big soldiers with their... Have you seen the police lately? They're fully armed in military stuff. Helmet, breastplate, they got all kinds of stuff on. So this was a big deal. This probably would scare anybody. So the soldiers come in, the officers come in, the police officers come in to arrest Jesus, to bound him and take him into where they were taking him. All right, verse 13.
First they took him to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jews that it was better to have one person die for the people.
Now, isn't that interesting? Say this with me. It's better to have one person die for the people, which is Jesus. He had that part right. Verse 15.
Simon Peter and another disciple followed Jesus.
Now remember, they're following Jesus. They're following the soldiers, the police, the officers. They're following them. Go.
Since that disciple was known to the high priest, he went with Jesus into the courtyard of the high priest. But Peter was standing outside at the gate. So the other disciple, who was known to the high priest, went out, spoke to the woman who guarded the gate, and brought Peter in.
Verse 17.
The woman said to Peter, "You are not also one of this man's disciples, are you?" He said, "I am not."
Now I want you to catch the words right there. Say this with me. Say, I am. You ever heard that before? Have you ever heard those words before? I am. Has anybody in the room ever heard those words? Who spoke those words? Jesus did. He said, I am that I am. Go tell him I am that I am. God, go tell him I am that I am. Peter reverses it. I am not. Verse 18.
Now the slaves and the police had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were standing around it and warming themselves. Peter also was standing with them and warming himself.
And verse 19.
Then the high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his teaching. Jesus answered, "I have spoken openly to the world.
I've spoken openly.
I have always taught in the synagogues and in the temple where all the Jews come together. I have said nothing in secret."
Nothing. It would have got revealed openly anyway.
"Why do you ask me? Ask those who heard what I said to them. They know what I said. When he had said this, one of the police standing nearby struck Jesus on the face, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?"
Let me ask you a question. Just in your own mind, just the way you are right now, would that upset you? Wouldn't it upset you? Forget Jesus. Wouldn't it upset you if you've seen anybody slap somebody across the face? That upset you, right? It might not upset you enough to take it into your own hands and do something, but it would accept you, right? It'd get you mad. Why are you doing that? Not that you might, you probably wouldn't do anything. All right, go.
When he had said this, "If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?"
What verse on?
24. Now, okay. This will be 24.
Okay.
Then Anna sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself.
He couldn't get away from that heat.
They asked him, "You are not also one of his disciples, are you?"
Are you one of his disciples? We've seen you hanging around him.
He denied it and said, "I am not."
He denies it again.
One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off.
Now stop right there for a minute. Do you remember that? They came to get Jesus in the garden and Peter took a sword out and sliced his ear off. Remember that? You do? Keep that in mind.
Asked, "Did I not see you?"
Where you at?
Oh, right at the end of 26. Okay. "Did I not see you in the garden with him?" Again, Peter denied it. And at that moment, the cock crowed.
So there was a witness. Somebody say a witness. Somebody say a witness. Jesus already spoke that witness. Didn't he? Okay. Now, when it's, just look at this again. In verse 15, Peter and his disciples follow Jesus. In verse 16, they're standing outside the gate. Verse 17, they're standing by a pot. They're wanting to get warm. He says, "It isn't me. I didn't do it. I am not the guy. I wasn't with this guy." Verse 25, he's standing there warming himself. He denies him again. Now I'm going to stop before I go jump into this part here. There's not anyone in this room, no one in this room, nobody in the room, that has not denied Jesus Christ one, two, or three times. And what I mean by that, you can deny him several different ways, but two ways I want to talk about. One way you can deny him outside the walls by not showing what you are. Number two, you can deny him by denying his word. And that's where he's at. He's denied the word of Jesus Christ. He already pre-warned him. He already told him, "You will deny me. I'll never deny you, Lord. Never will I deny you." So in verse 26, Peter gets told, he says, "You cut my ear off. We know it's you." "No, it wasn't me." Now I want you to think about this for a minute. Everything that you've done in the past, think about this for a second. Everything that you've done in the past against Satan's kingdom is going to get brought up to your face. Everything that you've done. So he takes his ear off, cuts his ear off. He's reminded of it. And you as ministers, everyone in the room's a minister. Everyone in this room's a minister. And somewhere down the line, Satan's going to pop up and say, "Look what you did to my kingdom." And you're going to be in the mode to deny God. To deny him. And some of you guys are sitting there and you're going, "I'll never deny him." That's what Peter said. When you're put to the flames, your mind is either going to say yay or no. "I don't want nothing to do with it." Your mind's a powerful thing. If Peter probably would have just listened and said, "You know, Father, strengthen me in my hour of weakness," which they did say that one time. They said, "Strengthen our faith, Father God." So if he probably would have done that, he probably, maybe, I don't know, well, the word's written, I know it is and always was it. It's settled in heaven, so it's there. He could have gained strength, I'm not sure, but when he, imagine the way he felt for a minute. The witness shows up and crows. And he says, "Wow, your word is true. Your word is true. Lift your hands up for a minute. And say this with me. Say, Father, your word is true. Your word is true. Now I want you to think about what I just told you. If you pray at all, even a little bit, if you pray, if you witness, if you talk about Jesus, somewhere down the road in your life, Satan is going to pop that up right in front of your face. He's going to try to hit you with sickness, unbelief, family problems, things that you were believing in, you wanted so bad, you knew God was going to do it, but it didn't happen. Not at the time you thought it was going to. You may come to a point where you say, I just don't believe this. I worked at POH, and I went past this room. It was room 127. It was on the first floor. And as I walked past this room, I was working there, as I walked past this room, I heard this younger man telling his elderly wife, or his elderly mother, come on, you always said Jesus could heal you. Get up out of that bed. What are you doing denying the faith now? But he was in a mocking sense. He was probably raised up in Christianity. It was probably shoved down his throat, and now he's rebelling against it. Somewhere down the line, you're going to rebel. Somewhere down the line, you're going to say, Father, I'm just having a tough time. How many of you know what Peter means? It means stone or rock. What a name given to Peter. You're the stone, you're the rock, and I'm going to build my church upon your revelation. And he denies him. Now I want you to follow me, please. Follow me to Romans 6, 22.
But now that you have been freed from sin and enslaved to God, the advantage you get is sanctification. The end is eternal life.
Read it again.
But now that you have been freed from sin.
Say now. Say right now.
I
am free. So she's reading Romans 6:22. It says, when you're freed from sin, it creates holiness. Say holiness.
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 Separation from the world and separation from everything. Deuteronomy 30 and 6. I want to give you a couple scriptures to read as we go through this. Deuteronomy 30 and 6. I hope I can read this. I was writing it down so fast.
Moreover, the Lord your God will circumcise your heart.
Say my heart. Somebody say that with me. Most important thing, guys. Your mind can deny God, but your heart can follow him. And that's a part of us, you and I, we have to change. Because we're living in a world right now where it's attacking our minds. Is Christianity right? Are you sure he's right? Are you sure he's the only way to God? And we stand up in all our vigor and our power and we say, yes, he's the only way to God. But would you die for that fact? Now don't look at me and say yes, because I'm going to tell you something. It might come to that point where you might have to say, you know something? I'm not going to deny God. I don't want to hear any roosters. I'm just going to believe God, and I'm going to believe that you're a rewarder of those that diligently seek you, and I'm going to believe that I belong to you. Lift your hands up for a minute. This is very important, brother. Very important. Because most people use church either as a crutch, or the house of God as a crutch, or it's just something you attend every now and then. And I'm not saying there's not always reasons. There could be reasons. But I'm going to tell you, as the day draws closer and closer, we're going to have to gather together even more and more to lift up the ones that might deny him. Read that, finish that, 36.
Moreover, the Lord your God will circumcise your heart and the heart of your descendants so that you will love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul in order that you may live.
Somebody say that again. Somebody read that B part. You might love the Lord with what?
All my heart and with all my soul.
The soul is the mind. If I can love God with all my heart and with all my soul, your heart can love God and follow God. And if you haven't renewed your mind's not going to follow. And you know what Scripture says about that mind? It's an enemy against God. Say enemy. Say it again, enemy. Enemy. The thing that I've learned with God, if he has spoke to you about something, sit down, shut up, it's going to happen. It will take place. Maybe not in your time, maybe not in my time. It will happen. Say it will happen. Say it again, it will happen. So I love him with all my heart. I have to love him with my soul, my mind, my reasoning. Reasoning. I have to love him with that. Romans 8:19 says we are the sons of God, the sons of the living God. Romans 8:19, would you read that to him? Oh, you guys pray for my allergies, will you?
For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God.
Read that one more time, please.
For the creation...
Say creation.
Creation.
Say creation.
Creation.
Say earth.
Earth.
Stars.
Stars.
Moon.
Moon.
Everything is waiting.
Everything.
On what?
Revealing
the sons of God to be revealed. That's what it's waiting on. And the world is puking right now. It can't take no more sin. It can't take no more sin. Verse 20.
For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it in hope. That the creation itself will be set free.
That's good. Oh, go ahead and finish it.
Set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God.
Now let me ask you just two quick questions. How many of you have felt recently or in the last month stress? Lift your hands up. Say stress.
Stress.
Say it again. Stress.
Stress.
Any kind of trouble. Trouble. Anything that would trouble your spirit. You have? So trouble and stress. There's two things to check to see if your mind's renewed or if it's being renewed. Say being renewed.
Being.
Say being renewed.
Being renewed.
You're either going to call out in faith or you're going to call out in unbelief. Oh, Jackie, have we not done that? Have we not done that? Father, are you done with us? Lord, is this happening? Is that happening? And we've just stood there and had this words of unbelief come forth. And God's in the background saying, everything that I've told you is going to come to pass in my time. In my time. So he says, all you have to do is stand still and know what? That I am God. Say, I am God. Say it again. Say,
I
the Almighty,
is God.
So we have to think this, constantly think this. So I want to show you the way the renewed mind works. God, I hope I wrote these. I wrote it down so quick. Psalms 23. Say, renewed mind.
Renewed.
Say it again. Renewed mind.
Renewed.
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 Renewed. Go.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not
stop
want.
Right there. That's just that verse alone right there. How many of you have ever used this verse? How many of you ever knew this verse was here? Somebody say, the Lord.
Lord
is
my
shepherd. What's a shepherd do?
Lead you.
He leads you. I shall not what?
Want.
That's a promise. Verse 2.
He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters.
Have you ever went to a river before or a creek and laid down beside it? What happens to you? You start dozing because you're at peace. So he's talking about peace here. Verse 3.
He restores my soul,
my mind. He restores my mind. He leads me in the right path for his name's sake. Say, for his name's sake. If you're not on the right path, his name's not there. If you're on the wrong path, his name is not there. Verse 4.
Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they
comfort me. Put your hands up for a minute. Everything seems to be exploding right now. Things are happening all over the place. And he's saying to us, he's saying, fear not. Be wise. Somebody say, be wise.
Be wise.
But fear not.
Yeah.
For I am with you.
Right.
My rod, my staff, they comfort you. I need comfort. Say, I need comfort.
I need comfort.
In God, not in the world. Verse 5.
You prepare a table before me in the presence
Stop
of
Stop right
my
there for a minute. Does anybody know when this is? When is it? Yell that a little bit louder.
Now.
Say, when is it?
Now.
Now, I was taught when I was a kid, that's when you got to heaven. There's no enemies in heaven. So you got to constantly renew your mind to this. You prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy. You anoint my head with oil, my mind. You anoint my mind with oil. My cup runneth over. My cup runneth over. Lift your hands up for a minute. We used to sing a song, "Fill my cup, Lord." Your cup will not run over until your mind is anointed and full. And then your cup will run over. You've anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. The heart and the soul get together and they make your body mind. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Okay, finish reading it, Jacqueline. Verse 6.
Surely, goodness and mercy.
Stop right there. I want everybody to say this with me. We're in times of trouble. Read this with me. Say, surely.
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 You know what surely means, right? Absolutely. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Verse 7. Ooh. There's not a 7 in the King James? Somebody say, my mind.
My mind.
Thank you, Father, for renewing it. Somebody say, my new,
brand new mind
wants to do things. Say, my mind thinks this way. Say it again.
My mind
thinks this way.
Glory to the Father
and glory to Jesus Christ. Somebody say, my mind thinks this way.
All things.
Somebody say, all things.
All things.
All things
are
possible. Romans 12, 2. Somebody say, all things. Listen, everybody look at me. How many of you guys have faith? Everybody in the room should raise your hand because you've been given the measure of faith, right? Right? Well, don't you try to judge your faith by her faith or her faith or his faith. Don't do that. You judge your own faith by the way you're walking, talking, and believing. That's how you judge your own faith. Read it.
Do not be conformed to this world.
Don't be conformed to the world. So he's saying, everything that's happening in the world, don't be conformed to it and don't think like it. Don't be like it.
But be
transformed by what?
The renewing of your mind.
By what? Mind renewed. So that you may discern what is the will of God. Take it.
What is good and acceptable and perfect.
Perfect. So all things are possible. Somebody say, my mind has to think this way. Rejoice.
Rejoicing.
In hope. Patience.
Tribulation.
Tribulation.
Continuing.
Steadfast in prayer. My mind has to think that way. And so many times we don't think that way. When something happens, did you ever think you might be able to just jump, instead of jumping on the phone, you might be able to just pray for yourself? Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. So he says, my mind has to be renewed constantly. It's a constant thing. And as the days draw closer and closer, you're going to have to renew your mind. Every day. Romans 12, 1 through 3. What is a renewed mind? What is a renewed mind? I'm up here preaching. What is a renewed mind? You keep your mind on the Lord. Singing? What's a renewed mind? Huh? What's a renewed mind? One that thinks this, talks this, and ministers in this. That's a renewed mind. That's what a renewed mind thinks. A renewed mind never thinks about killing, getting you back, destroying you, or you have lack. Lift your hands up for a minute. Say, my renewed mind only operates in patience, tribulation. No matter what happens, my mind is in hope. Somebody praise him a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. Finish this 12, 1 through 3.
I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect.
And verse 3 again, please.
For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned.
Anybody in here have a flash? Temper? Anybody? Stand to your feet if you do. Flash. It don't take much to just flash it. Flash, 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 flash. Flash temper. You want to get rid of it? You got to renew your mind. You'll get rid of it. You'll get rid of it. Thoughts. Somebody say this with me. Say thoughts.
My thoughts
are the beginning.
Beginning
of everything.
Everything.
So what I thought yesterday about you, or about you, you and you, if I don't relate or take care of it right then, at one moment in our friendship, you're going to get it. You're going to get it. That's a flash temper. God don't want that there. But Pastor Mark, I can control it. He don't want it there to control. Somebody say, Father.
Father.
Create in us a right mind.
A right mind.
Okay. So thoughts are the beginning of everything. You have the thought. The thought comes in. And then somewhere down the line, you explode if they've done you wrong. So Colossians 3:1-3.
So if
hey, you guys don't think because you're 60 years old or 45 or 50 or 60 years old, you're above this. Because there's elders that are 80 and 90 that even haven't even corrected this yet.
So
isn't that right? Somebody say amen. That's the reason Jesus thought little babies were so powerful, or children were so powerful, because they ain't been polluted by adults yet. We haven't put our poison in them. When you put your poison in them, they start thinking like you think. Ugly. Isn't that right? Sure, it's right. A verse. Go ahead, read it.
So if you have been raised with Christ.
If.
If.
Okay.
Seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
And then verse 2.
Set your minds on things that are
above.
And
that, I'm going to tell you something, guys. The whole ministry, everybody would say either to you, to me, or Bobby started out with us, 4 or 5 people started out with us. Is that all you guys think about is the Spirit? Is that all you think about is that stuff? Somebody say, put your hands up and say, that's all I think about. Somebody say it again, that's all I think about. You know what we need to start thinking about? Revival. That's what we need to start thinking about. We need to start thinking about the power of God and people's marriages being healed. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things of this world. Verse 3.
For you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God.
Say, I want my mind to die. Your mind is filled with sickness, disease. It's filled with all kinds of stuff. He's saying, fix it. You go home and read. Write this down. Psalms 112. Go home and read it. Fix your mind with it. Psalms 112. Write that down. Say, my mind has to be fixed. Say it again. My mind has to be fixed. Isaiah 55:7. Would you read that, please?
Let the wicked forsake their way and the unrighteous their thoughts.
Forsake it. Say, forsaking my thoughts, but I have to replace it with something. You can't do this standing up in a mirror. Go.
Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon.
Okay, now I want you to go to the top and read it again.
Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts.
Let them return to the Lord. Let who return to the Lord? Huh? Let who return to the Lord? Let what return to the Lord? Your thoughts. Let them return unto the Lord. Let your thoughts return. And when your thoughts return unto the Lord, you get saved. Amen? Amen? So chase them things out of there. Say, I'm going to chase out sickness, disease, everything that's in my head, I'm going to chase it out. You know, your mind's a very powerful thing. That's when men get hooked on that garbage that's on the internet. They can't hardly break it or get away from it because it imprints their mind. And it puts an imprint there and they can't chase it out. So Jesus said, those only come out by fasting and prayer. That's the only way you can cleanse somebody's mind is fasting and prayer. A demon that's inside the spirit, you can get rid of him quick. Real fast. Use the name of Jesus. But when they're in your mind, you can't get rid of them. Fasting and prayer is the only way. So somebody say this with me. Say, casting down thoughts that are against God's word and my imagination that is against God's word. 2 Corinthians 10, 3 through 6.
Indeed, we live as human beings, but we do not wage war according to human standards.
Read it again.
Indeed, we live as human beings, but we do not wage war according to human standards.
And so you're not thinking always to get back or to create something against somebody. Verse 4.
For the weapons of our warfare are
Have you
not...
ever used these weapons? Somebody stand up to your feet and put your hands in there. Stand up, put your hands in there. Have you ever used these weapons?
Yeah.
You have? Where'd you use them? I'm going to tell you something. You guys that are not connected with God, you better get connected because the days ahead are going to be ugly. So he says the weapons of our warfare are not mere, they're not human, but they have divine power to destroy strongholds. We destroy strongholds and arguments. Read it again.
For the weapons.
I'm going to tell you something. I thank God for you every day. You and I have never argued. Ever. It isn't us. It's God. Who don't argue? When we first got married, we was married about a week. She slapped me across the face. And I slapped her back. I said, you don't hit me, we'll start right out from the beginning. You don't hit me and I won't hit you.
Oh boy.
Somebody say, for the weapons of our warfare. They're not human. They're divine power. They can destroy strongholds. And what else? Look at your neighbor and say this to him. Say, I will never bring a railing accusation against you. Because if I do, my mind suffers for it. Verse 5.
And every proud obstacle raised up against the knowledge of God, and we take every thought captive to obey Christ.
So you don't go, I'm taking this thing out of my head and bringing it into captivity. You got to find somewhere where it says whatever you're fighting and exchange it. Say, exchange it. Verse 6.
We are ready to punish every disobedience when your obedience is complete.
Read it again to them.
We are ready to punish every disobedience when your obedience is complete.
When you guys get your disobedience together, we're going to take care of the rest of this disobedience. Amen. Amen? Amen? Okay, you can be seated. Give me just a minute here. 2 Timothy 1:7. 2 Timothy 1:7. Stay in the same book.
For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice.
Whoa. I love this verse. I love this verse. That's what I mean when I say panty waist. That's what I mean. Coward. Chicken. Not manly. Go.
But rather a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline.
Oh, my, my, my. Somebody read that to me again. Every church, let the church read it to us. You don't say none. Go. 1, 2, 3. Go.
God,
Somebody say this with me. Say, I reject.
Reject.
Totally reject.
Totally
the spirit of fear.
Spirit of
fear. Say, I reject it.
I reject it.
My job, my mind is to please the Father. Don't you want to be whole? Peace of mind is being whole. Peace of mind. You know, God can, He's the only one that can do that for you. If you're seeking peace, He's the only one that can give you peace. He's the only one that can do it. Have you ever felt the peace of God? Now, I'm not talking about when you lay down at night and your belly's full and you feel good, you got new shoes on. I'm talking about the peace of God where there's nothing worldly attacking your mind and you're just totally at rest. Would you give $1 million for that? I would. I'd give $1 million to walk in that all the time. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So the power of love and discipline. Say discipline. Say this with me. Say God.
God
Almighty.
Will.
Supply.
Supply.
All.
My.
Needs.
According to.
I got to get my mind right. According to.
His.
Riches.
In.
Glory. Now I found this out just walking with the Lord. The one that has to keep repeating that to himself is the one that isn't going to happen. The one that gets that is the one that repeats it or uses it one time, lays it down, and then walks with God, and everything just falls in his lap.
Amen.
Somebody lift your hands up. Did you just hear what I just said?
Yes.
You don't have to keep repeating this. Use it one time. Say, Father,
you said
you
would supply
all of my needs
according to
your
riches
in
glory.
I'm going to get my mind right. Say, I'm going to get my mind right.
I
will overcome the mind with the Word of God, led by the Spirit, and walking in the Spirit. Romans 7:23. Put your hands down. Romans 7:23.
But I see in my members another law at war.
And it's there. It's there. That law, that other member, that law that's warring inside your mind, it is there. You have to put it down. And you put it down with Scripture. So when something pops up, Scripture pops up in your head. Oh, got that. Yes, and I've won. Say, I've won.
I've won.
Go, Jackie.
But I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members.
So there's definitely a law there. You got a human mind. You got to whip it. We got to whip it into shape. Beat it. Say, beat it. So 1 Thessalonians says to do this, and everybody wants to do this. They want to have a vessel, and they want to possess their vessel. Say, possess.
Possess
my vessel. Someone that cannot control their spirit is like a city without walls. No walls. Say, no walls.
No walls.
Everything comes in. Everything. Say, everything.
Everything
comes in. A city with no walls. Can anybody think of a city that's got walls? Can anybody think of a country that's got walls? You can't think of a country that has walls. Hello. Doesn't China have walls around the whole country, or at least that side? City without walls, always afraid that something's going to attack that you can't win. 1 Kings 8:35. Lift your hands up again just for a second and say this with me. Say, the rain
of the Holy Spirit
is going to touch my mind today. And what I see myself as,
I will not see myself that way any longer.
Jackie, if we could just possess this, I'm telling you, when heaven is shut up and there is no rain, because they have sinned against you. You read this, guys.
Shut up, the rain,
Somebody lift your hands back up and say, it's going to rain today. 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 Now, we're going to be bold real quick with your eyes closed and your hands lifted up. If you have a sin you cannot break, do not be ashamed. Do not be afraid. Nobody's even going to open their eyes to look to see who gets up. I want you to stand up and get in the center of the room. Or matter of fact, come to the front so I can lay my hand on you quickly. If you got a sin you can't break, it's got you. It's got your, it's gripping you. Grip, grip. Boy. With your eyes closed and your hands lifted up, I want everyone that's standing up here, say this with me. Say, sin is hard. You think about what I just said to you. Sin is hard. And what we're after is a renewed mind and the peace of God. Say, peace of God. That's what we want. Did you hear what I ministered today? Did you hear what I was saying to you? When I was ministering and she was reading those scriptures to you about the mind, about renewing the mind, about the mind being at peace even with your enemy. It's obvious you came up, but did you hear that in your mind? You did? Well, it sparked something. And now when I come down and lay hands on you, you have to finish the job. Would you stand still? You have to finish the job. All of you grab hands. Eyes closed. Keep your eyes closed. Don't worry, I'm not going to throw water on you. There's another person in here that doesn't come up. They're fighting the most hellish sin you can fight. But they think it's hid. It's not hid. It's not hid at all. But they think it's hid. It's not hid. Did you hear what I spoke today? Do not open your eyes. Did you hear what I was speaking today? Sometimes things follow us down through generations. Isn't that right? They follow us down through generations. Please hold hands. Quiet. Can somebody take that child or will she cry? Somebody grab her. Thank you, brother. Grab hands. Keep your eyes closed. What I'm going to do is I'm going to have you come up one at a time. I remember Sister Mary did this to me and threw the Bible on my chest. The biggest Bible I've ever seen in my life. It was about 6 foot by 6 foot. But it was the beginning of my mind being corrected. And boy, it worked. I'm telling you, it worked. Do you know what instructions are? You do? Then close your eyes. I want you in the blue first. Brother, I'm going to tell you what the Lord showed me. He showed me a darkness that engulfs your feet. A darkness that engulfs your whole life. And your mind's constantly, you cannot go over this. You cannot beat this. You have to, it just isn't going to work, Pastor Mark. It is going to work today. That thing's going to be broke off you. The anointing's going to come on you, brother. And that thing is going to come off you and that darkness is going to leave you and it's not going to return.
Do you hear what I just said? It's not coming back. It's going to be gone forever. Gone forever. And ever. And ever. And ever. Isn't that right, Jackie?
Yeah.
I said, isn't that right?
Amen.
Oh, getting back up.
Amen.
No, brother. You don't have to be that way. Your family can be that way, but you're not going to be that way. But you're not going to be that way. Your family can be that way, but not you. The anointing's on you.
I don't want to be that way.
You're defeated, but God's going to bring you victory right now. You've been defeated. Words can change it. The Word of God can change this. And that's what's doing today. We've sparked this thing in your head, brother. And I'm telling you, who the sun sets free is free indeed. Take it now. Take it now. Take it now. Next in the green. Get up to your feet, everybody in the room. Yes, sir. Lift your hands up. That's a bad spirit, brother, I'm telling you. Horrible spirit. Because when it gets in you, it's hard to break loose. Well, brother, Jesus said it like this. They only come out by fasting and prayer when it's in the mind. And we've been fasting. Lift your hands up and say, I have been fasting. I've been praying. And Daniel, can I call that out? Will be freed from lust. The wind of the Holy Spirit's going to touch him and break, literally destroy the powers of darkness in his life. And his mind, his soul will be set free in Jesus' name. Take it now. Take it now. Next, please. Stand right there with your hands lifted up and your eyes closed, please. When I was ministering, I was watching you, and God kept saying to me, he kept repeating it over and over again, her joy is gone. The joy for salvation's gone. The enemy has come in like a flood, and I'm going to change her life today. I am going to change her thoughts and give her mine this morning. Take it. Take it. I don't know if she's been dating somebody or somebody's been around her trying to get her to date. I hope she don't do it. In the blue. In the blue. Daniel, come right here, brother. No, you're going to do it from over there. Right there, stand in front of that fan, look out. Lift your hands up. Say, I have been called by name. Jesus has called me by name. And I will finish my mission in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Brother, the Holy Spirit was telling me you have a very small opinion of yourself, and God's going to change that opinion. Sometimes we just, we think we have a high opinion, but really it's a cover-up. And God says, I'm going to do a little work in your heart today and your mind. Now. 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 Next. Come, 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 come. Is there somebody in here pregnant other than the person we know of? You're pregnant? Come here. Have I ever met you before? Huh? I haven't? Take her down there. Don't say a word to me. Take her right down there. Ever lift her hands up and close her eyes? You. You. I want you to just lay hands on her. Don't get loud. Don't do anything. Just put your hands on her. Lift your hands up. You battling the same stuff over and over again? Is that why you're up here? What?
My past.
I know that thing's ugly, isn't it? Lift your hands up, close your eyes. You heard the word this morning? Free. Free. My words, man, I feel that on her. What a And the orange. You stand right there. Everybody, please point your hand. I want to tell everybody in the room, I want you to listen to me just for a second. Everybody in the room. If God has given you something to do in God's house and you haven't been doing it or you haven't done it, maybe you think it's beneath you. You're not going anywhere until you do what God asked you to do. Nowhere. Neither is your family. Yes. Lift your hands up, please. Yes. There's healing on you right now. Wow. 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 Now, whoa, Linda. Come on up. Right down there. I can always tell when the anointing's on my suit coat, brother. It gets real hot. There's a powerful anointing on that young lady right there in the white going there. Jesus, mighty God. Darkness is bound in Jesus' name. Darkness is bound in Jesus' name. Darkness is bound. Bound in the name of the Lord. 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 Jackie? Oh, Blue. That's a faithful man right there. That's a faithful man. There's another one sitting up there. There's all kinds of them in here. It's just the two that came to my mind. You're hearing a turquoise or blue or whatever color that is. I've never prayed over this for you before. Lift your hands up, close your eyes. See, I'm one that believes that when you get saved, everything's not broke off you. You get saved from what Adam did, and the rest is a walk with God. Glory to glory, faith to faith. Amen? Generational garbage, I break it in the name of the Lord. Generational filth, I break it in the name of the Lord. Generational disease, I break it in the name of the Lord. For by your stripes we've been made whole, and the power of God touch her right now in the name of Jesus. And heal the broken heart, Lord Father mighty God. Heal the broken heart, Lord Father mighty God, in Jesus' mighty name. Who the Son sets free is free indeed. Breaking the power, the chains that hold us. Breaking the power in the name of the living God. I take authority in the name of Jesus. And I loose the power of God in her right now. In Jesus' mighty name. Touch her, Jackie. Hey, I don't know you. Come back up here a minute. Yeah, you. You're the one who was pregnant, aren't you? Didn't you? Who'd you come with? Do you know people here or something? Have her lift your hands up. Let's see. Right here in the roses. Yeah, get them dimes, brother. Yeah, I don't need, oh, 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 not that way. It's obvious that you had to have a man around you somewhere. You step right over there. It's obvious you had to have a man around you somewhere. Everyone in this room, lift your hands up and close your eyes. Get it by the elbows. It's obvious you had to have a man around you to get pregnant. Well, you better not expect too much from him. Do you hear me? You better not expect too much from, I don't even know who it is, but you better not expect a lot from him. Now! Jesus! You didn't even have to come up. It got broke off you when you were standing down right down there. Now.
Oh, no.
Now.
No. Oh.
Right here. You know what I see around her? Jackie, let her go. Let her go. You know what I see around her? Worms. Get her. You ever dabbled in the occult? I see worms. They're gone. It's gone. I break its power right now. I break its power right now. I break its power right now in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. What's she saying? That's why I said it was broke off you already when you came up here. And God showed me these worms around you. It's demonic. God showed me these worms trying to just destroy you and kill you. Who the sun sets free is free indeed. Your path's going to be clear. Your path, your anointing is going to be clear in Jesus' mighty name. Next. Brother, do me a favor. Reach down there and get her feet. Put your hands on her feet real quick. Where's your wife at? Is your wife available? If you would. Hey, go get his wife, would you? Somebody go get Adam's wife real quick. Huh? The lady going down. Don't let her go yet. Ooh. Here, brother, this, I put oil on this for that. Put your hands on her back. This might help a little one up there, this little lady. You're going to help your husband there. Did you hear what I called up here? What was it?
Sin to be broken off of you.
The sin to be broke off you? What is it? Can you say it out loud? Can't say it?
Thoughts.
Can't say it?
Evil lust.
Love. See what she has called out? That takes a lot of guts to call something like that out. I feel twins in here, man. Put your hands up. I feel twins. Somebody mark that down and put the date down, will you? I feel twins. I don't know where they're at, but I feel them. I feel twins. That ain't you, is it? You ain't gonna have no twins, right?
I have twin granddaughters.
Twin granddaughters? How old are they?
They're four.
Four twin little granddaughters. I wonder if that's what I'm picking up. Twin little granddaughters. Really? And what about the guy that's around him?
My daughter's married. She has six daughters.
Six of them?
The twins are youngest.
They're the youngest, huh? Wow.
Well, I am blessed. I am blessed every day of my life. I am blessed when I wake up in the morning till I lay my head to rest. I am blessed.
How you doing there? That Sunday, you guys, Jackie really got tough. I mean, a miracle happened on her. Remember, she kept going down, up and down, up and down. What? Things began to happen, didn't they, Jacqueline? Didn't they? Things began to happen, didn't they? Margaret, you're so sweet. This is one of the sweetest people I know. I have never heard her say anything bad about anybody. Did you know that? I've never even heard her mention anybody, even if people were trying to draw her into a conversation. Isn't that something? Thank you, my brother. Thank you, Lord. Somebody say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody say, thank you, mighty God.
Thank you, mighty God.
I'm going to look that up and see what those worms were. Can you guys give me 5 more minutes? Romans 7, 4 through 6. Would you read that? Yeah.
In the same way, my friends, you have died to the law through the body of Christ, so that you may belong to another, to him who has been raised from the dead, in order that we may bear fruit for God. While we were living in the flesh, our sinful passions, aroused by the law, were at work in our members to bear fruit for death. But now we are discharged from the law, dead to that which held us captive, so that we are slaves not under the old written code, but in the new life of the Spirit.
Say, thank you, Lord. Somebody say, I am free. So to be in the presence of God is freedom, right? Romans 8, 7, would you read that? A couple more quick scriptures, please. Romans 8, 7.
For this reason, the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot.
Now, I want everybody to repeat after me, please. Say, the mind, my mind,
must have
a print,
print
in my mind,
made of hope,
anchor for the soul. Hebrews 6:19. Would you read that?
We have this hope, a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul, a hope that enters the inner shrine behind the curtain.
Hope. So the Bible says in Genesis, it says, Abraham hoped against hope. He had a bunch of it. Abraham hoped, he had the print in his mind of what God promised. And just look at this real quick. Genesis 15:5. And stay in Genesis for just 1 second. Genesis 15:5.
He brought him outside and said, look toward heaven and count the stars.
Now, but he's looking at the stars. He hoped against hope, so he gave him something to imprint his mind with, the stars.
If you are able to count them. Then he said to him, so shall your descendants be.
So he saw the stars and his seed, and it gave him an imprint in his mind, so he hoped against hope. Genesis 22:12. Remember, we're still talking about the mind. Genesis 22:12.
He said, do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me.
And he still had that imprint in his mind. You promised me the seed was going to come through my son. He had that print in his mind, and we have the promises. Okay, Genesis 26:4. Stick with me, please.
I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven, and will give to your offspring all these lands, and all the nations of the earth shall gain blessing for themselves through your offspring.
So he had the vision, he had an imprint, seed, stars, God's word. Now, this is kind of neat here. I want everybody to repeat with me. Say there's 7,000 promises in God's word. And God said in the Old Testament, I have 7,000 men that have not bowed their knee to Baal. I want you to say this with me. Say 7,000 promises 7,000 that will come to pass. And this is my imprint in my mind. And now I have hope against hope. And we're going to close with this. 2 Peter 1, 17 through 21. Second Peter 1, 17 through 21.
For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that voice was conveyed to him by the majestic glory, saying, "This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased." We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. So we have the prophetic message more fully confirmed. You will do well to be attentive to this as to a lamp shining in a dark place until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. First of all, you must understand this, that no prophecy of Scripture is a matter of one's own interpretation. Because no prophecy ever came by human will, but men and women moved by the Holy Spirit spoke from God.
Hope against hope, say God's promises. I'm going to renew my mind with them. And Satan cannot stop them coming to pass. Amen. Yes. Hey, she needs a mic. I can't tell.
Miraculous. Margaret, can you hear me? Margaret, take it from there. I'm not a good speaker.
Last Friday. It started from last Friday. Sister Dory and I was praying. And we were praying Acts 4, where Pastor Mark was saying for God to stretch forth his hands with signs and wonders and miracles. And we was praying for a miracle. Well, I had been, like, intercession was hitting me, and it was like I couldn't understand. I was just be crying and crying. So Monday, Pastor Mark called me, and he said, "Sister, what was you crying about?" And I said, "I don't know." I said, "Pastor Mark, I've just been crying. I don't know." She called me Monday afternoon, and she said, "Your ex-husband was in an accident." And I was like, "Really? Are you kidding me?" And she said, "No." She said, "I was on the large freeway going south, and this car went past me so fast and hit another car and went up the medium. It's a cement medium. And came back down.
And I don't know how he survived that, but he was unscathed.
But she said, "I didn't know who it was," and she was prompted by the Holy Spirit to stop. And when she stopped, she said, "Sir, are you okay?" And he said, "Yeah." Well, she said, "Is there anybody I can call for you?" And she said, and he said, "My son is in Ohio, my daughters are in Vegas." And she said, "Well, is there anybody else?" And he gave her his AAA card. On it was his name. And she said, "Arnell Isbell." She goes, "I know a Margaret Isbell." He said, "That's my ex-wife." And so she talked to him, and she said, "I remember meeting you years ago, over 30 years ago, she met him." And he didn't remember her. So after I hung up from her, this is what really blew my mind. After I hung up from her, I called them, and he said, The car was sitting still, and I don't know what happened to the car. He didn't know. Okay, I said, were you drinking? He said, well, I slept it off. But when she told me, I thought it was the guardrail on the right side. They were in the left medium. The rail that sets the north and south separates them. Had he went over, it could have been a multiple car accident. Or when he came back down, had his car rolled, could have been a multiple accident. It was sitting there. Nobody got hurt. He walked away without a scratch. He said he was sore. So when I found all this out from her, I called him. And he said, I was real drunk. He said, I drank too much. He said, it went vague to me. And I said, but the car wasn't sitting still. He goes, I don't know. His car is a total. He was driving a Volvo. And it was total, total. You know what he said? That's why I say we have to pray. When God tells us to pray, we have to pray. He said, it was a miracle. He said, God is trying to get my attention. I'm not going to drink no more. He said, I've been promising and I've been cutting down. He said, but I'm not going to drink no more. And you know what? I believe God. I believe him this time because he was scared. He said, when I think about it, because he don't remember. He said everything went blurry to him. But now when he thinks about it, he goes, I could have killed somebody. It could have been a lot of people got killed. And he said, and I walked away with nothing but some soreness. I said, God, I thank you. But her was a divine appointment because you know what? Anybody else, I wouldn't have never known. But because she knew me, she was able to call me. If it's somebody else and they helped him, that would have been the end of it. And I wouldn't have known, and he didn't know. He was blurry. But she knew and she called me. That's why we don't know what God has planned for us. And he uses us. And like I told him, I said, there was a time I would have prayed that I wish you had died in the accident. But you know what? I thank God that he gave me a forgiving heart. And I told him a long time ago, I forgive you. I forgive you for what you did to me. And God is awesome. God is awesome.
Woo! Woo! Jesus. Ann, how you doing?
If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you may come up now to receive communion. Jesus said that as we do, as often as we take up the communion, we think, remember him. Remembering what he did for us. And when we eat the bread and the drink, the cup, we are receiving the blessings which comes to us through the death of Jesus on the cross. Our sins are forgiven and we are made whole. We are saved from condemnation. We are accepted in the beloved. We are qualified for the inheritance as heirs and joint heirs with Christ. We are sanctified, set apart in Christ. We are seated. We are sealed with the Holy Spirit. We are made righteous before God. We have the hope of eternal life. And we are blessed in Christ with all spiritual blessings. Jesus did this once for all. And we should see each other through the eyes of God. God is not a respecter of persons, and neither should we be. God created us all, black, white, yellow, brown, whatever. And that's the way we should see each other, through his eyes. He sent his son to save all of us. And we are all in one with him. And when we take communion, we remember that. He just didn't single each one of us out. We all have a purpose, and he has a plan for each one of us. And all of us are not an eye. We're all not a foot. We're all not a nose. But we all put together, just like the physical body is all put together with different members, so is the body of Christ. We all have gifts in here. We all are different, yet we're all one. And we're one with each other, and we're one with God in Christ. Christ is the center, and we all are one. It's like a puzzle, and he's the centerpiece, and we all fit in that puzzle with him. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We thank you this morning. We thank you that you died for each one of us. That we are not the same. That we are all brothers and sisters in here. And not just in here, Lord, but you did it for every created being. You died. And every drop of blood that you shed has someone's name on it. Lord Jesus, we thank you. And we remember that you did it for us. You took those stripes on your back. You took the bruises. You took the humiliation. Being spit on. No shame. We thank you, Lord Jesus. And we take up your body now. In your precious name. And this cup, the blood that you shed for us, where each drop, our name is on it. It's blood that washes us. This blood that makes us worthy. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your precious blood, that it washes us clean, makes us holy, makes us pure before you. It's not us, but it's your blood that does it. And it forgives us for all our sins. That we stand before you as your children. To each other, we might look all dirty and ragged, but to you, we are precious. Because you saw the joy that was set before you. You saw that one day we would accept you. And we thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your blood now. In your precious name, amen.
Testing. Hello, hello.
Testing, testing, testing.
Praise God, everyone. What's going on? Well, everyone knows we started our group. Well, you guys, if you don't know, Crown Servants, but we just been excited and just been doing God's work. I don't know if you guys can hear me. Can you hear me? Just excited about doing God's work. We've been making music, inspired by other people, but we got this song that we want to perform. It's a slower worship kind of song, and it's just basically letting you know, until you turn your life right to Christ, everything's going to go wrong. And there's kind of a little story in there. So just kind of listen to the words. I don't know if you want to tell me anything else, because
it's pretty much our testimonies to how God pretty much brings us back to where we are now.
Working
even though
him.
We're still a work in progress.
That's right, yes. But it's all for Christ. So we're ready when you are, Linda. Turn just a little, please. Hear that? Pray to God. It's up to you guys to surrender your life. Let's do it before it's too late. I'm telling you.
I was lost in the crowd and I didn't know how to catch a breath till I surrendered my life to him and gave up my old man. Told me I can't have all things in him, but I just ran foolishly, compromising his plan. I can do it on my own.
On my own.
But I was wrong and the enemy came. He tried to take me out the game. Distractions came from whichever way. I turned to every spirit in the book. My life was lit and man it was shook. Doing things I said I'd never do. I realized I can't do nothing without you.
Trying to stop us.
Father God, I failed you so many times. What I thought was really you, the devil in disguise. He had me blinded. All of his lies telling me I don't need God. I'll be alright. He had me out in the clubs, drinking, living careless on the edge without thinking. Digging myself into a ditch, I'm sinking. Suffocate, gasping and wheezing. But someone came and pulled me out that hole. Told me to come out from among all ye people. Took me up that old path.
A new road. That's what confesses across yourself. Serve me, you mistake it. Jesus is
oh my goodness, sorry guys.
You breakthrough.
If I can't sorry,
do it, you can do it too. Take you out that old life. Let him give you new
because I can't do nothing. I
can't do nothing. I can't do nothing on my own. You to know he cares. He'll turn your life around.
He'll turn it around.
God sent his son from above to show you all his love. Was lost but now I'm found. I was lost but now I'm found. He picked me up from the ground. I can't do nothing without you.
I can't
now I'm found. He picked me up from the ground. I can't do nothing without you.
I can't do nothing.
Y'all wanna know why?
Because
you. I can't do nothing. I can't do nothing. I can't do nothing
on my own.
Hey, coming home.
Love you guys. Sorry for the dismissal.
Man, I'm going to tell you two something. You guys are good, man. I'm telling you. That is something else. Brother, I didn't know you could sing like that. My words, man. You're to be an opera. That was good. Wasn't that good, brother? Whoo! Tina, if you could only sing like that, sister. Hey, AD, come here, close us in prayer, brother.
AD, AD, AD.
AD.
AD's getting married. AD's getting married.
Brother, grab a mic. Gotta get a mic here, brother. Providence.
Everybody close your eyes and bow your head. Lord, Heavenly Father, I would just like to pray for everybody that's in here. They can make it out, come out and show support to God, because he shows us support through anything and through everything that we go through. And I just want to also pray that everybody gets home safe in whatever you're going to go through today, and enjoy with your families. And happy Father's Day to all the fathers that are out there in their kids' life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, brother. Thank you.
Candy bars.
I ate them.
That's why I
We forgot Mother's Day candy bars, and I said, well, we can't do daddies. We can't do daddies.